I'm here today to spend the day with one of our sponsored riders, Lee Johnston, at Alton Park for the practice day of the British Superbikes. Get a look at what goes on and what's involved in a British Superbikes round. Let's go and find Lee, see what he's up to. No, he's director.
Neil's top blogger, aren't you, Neil? So, I tell you what, you may actually get some money out of this one.
No.
That's what makes the world go round.
Right there.
What are you? Hi, mate. What's happening? He was at Goodwood last weekend and just wore all his normal clothes. It's old school uniform on. What's happening? Are you working? You look like you're trying to do somebody over.
I'm officially working.
Yeah? Nice to meet you.
Good to meet
you. Alright, thanks.
Yeah. Nice to meet you, mate. What can I take off?
How's it going? You alright?
They're big. 1:15, yeah.
Coffee got salt.
What time am I out at then? 1:45? Yeah?
What?
Just go look in the truck.
Yeah.
So where do you have your dinner normally?
So we get hospitality with McCams, which is obviously the Superbike Yamaha team. We just do a deal with them for the year, so they feed all the mechanics, and if you ever want to bring some sponsors and different things.
Do you have to pay separately to use their hospitality?
Yeah, it's all paid by per meal, per day, whatever.
Yeah.
Did they like eating then?
They did.
Yeah, we're bloody out. We're going to miss dinner, aren't we? Or?
Yeah. You're going to miss dinner.
Are you going to go out? You'll be fit to
we're
go
just
out.
Going to miss the first 20 minutes of the session.
Yeah, we'll have
as well as the 25 minute session.
Yeah. We'll just wave as you go past.
I'll just keep some, but you want, you're going to go out of time to get yours. Or are you not bothered?
I don't need to.
You can tell them that we'll have it afterwards, so tell them to keep
it. So, how many people is there? One, two, three.
A few.
Neil's
going to have some food here. He bought some food for Wednesday night. So
Neil's 4, Kev's 5.
No, Neil's going to have food here.
Neil's going to have food here.
He bought a meal to have on Wednesday night when we went to the pub.
Saturday today.
So
yeah, but he'll eat that on his dinner, won't he?
No,
probably. That was a meal for two then when he's gone.
Yeah. Because he has to walk all the way down there to eat his dinner. Whereas you could eat that here.
Stop picking on
surely he's not going to worry about walking down there to eat dinner.
Yeah. He's petrified of losing weight. He doesn't want to be walking anywhere.
Well, he's got a profile to keep up, hasn't he?
Big Neil.
Big fat grumpy Neil.
You get as bad as him. That old couple at the fence this morning sort of nodded me across. So. How's Neil this morning? Is he happy? I went, he's never fucking happy.
What, they were Neil fans, weren't they?
Oh, yeah, he is. He's in the videos. I said he ain't, because all he does is that to the camera.
Got loads of fans. I added them to our team WhatsApp group, because when you add someone to WhatsApp group, you can track where their phone is. So I can see where you are. And I could literally see him on his phone. He was going like this. I was worrying about.
Do you have them t-shirts out of here? Yeah. I love Rolls-Royce Cabral.
I've not seen them. Some random dude.
I don't know if they're still in there.
We don't know who he was or anything.
Paul Ashton, I think, is his name.
Oh, that's Ashley that he used
no,
to.
No, it wasn't him.
No, not him.
No, it's special.
Yeah.
The bloke was wearing one as well, so he turned up wearing one. He said, oh, I've got something, he's wearing it. He was dead proud of it. Oh, he loved it.
The funniest one was still the test at Snetterton, where that couple was stood outside the front of the garage and they went, oh, can we have a photo, please? So Lee stood up, no, not with you, with Neil.
Yeah.
And then it was the bloke that went and stood with him and the wife that took the photo. It was like, are you having a laugh?
Yeah. Neil was not embraced about that one.
It doesn't make as long as it's the wife that wants to.
You'd have to worry, wouldn't you, after that?
The bloke with the t-shirt, he was like, can you make sure Lee puts these on his vlog?
Yes. There you go, they're on the vlog.
They're on the MyMoto vlog. Am I getting on the back?
Yeah.
This class is a pillion ladder, I reckon. What are these electric bikes like then?
Oh, just like, I'm gonna, once the season's over, because it says in the race block, once the season's over, I'm gonna look back over the road grind to level.
Yeah.
I'm just using the road grind up to it in house and stuff. Maybe in the leads or whatever. It does 70k on a charge. It does like 70k.
What's your top speed?
75.
That's alright then. We're jumping off. Is that going to give you a load more grip then for the weekend?
No, it's different rubber. Some reason, like, so you see, like, even in MotoGP, when the Moto2 use Dunlops and the GP boys use Bridgestones, it seems to upset the tyre.
Does it?
Rubber, yeah.
Right. I always thought it kind of gave you a bit more traction and cleared the dust
a bit. For some reason, different rubber affects different.
Do you gain much grip over the weekend then from like practice day
once
through
to? Yeah, the track rubber's in, especially because it's rained all day yesterday, so the track's green. Even though you wouldn't think of watching these ones. Quite cold breeze, isn't it?
Yeah, hopefully you get good weather for the whole weekend. It, that time of year where it can just be completely different from one day to the next, can't it?
Especially in England, in Ireland, sunny all the time.
Yeah, obviously, yeah. Huddersfield? It's raining all the time.
It's like Huddersfield.
Something I learnt about Huddersfield when I went to uni there, doesn't matter where you're going, it's uphill.
Oh, yeah.
Probably good for training.
It's good for shape. Yeah. Well, it makes you like going uphill.
I know, yeah, for Friday.
Sometimes I get here on Thursday and the campsites are empty.
Yeah, of course you did. What are your headlights for? Endurance racing.
Right about this point at the TT,
you're absolutely. Is it not like that for this? Do you not get the same? Yeah. No, yeah, of course.
Thank you.
not doing plug chops, are they, Neil? They're not doing plug chops when they're rolling in.
Plug chops.
Yeah. Is that old school? Is that when you had to do jetting and needles?
Yeah, no. I've seen that. Got a laptop in that way.
Yeah. That's when there was a fine art to getting them running right.
I've still got one of them, haven't I?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Like what you say, like it.
You know me, I like to find the positive out of every negative. I like it. You've
done well there.
Yeah.
What's that for something?
Oh, just this side of the game.
You'll have a ready meal for two, about half an hour, plus two or three bags of fruit. And what chocolate have you got? Oh, I bet you'll have chocolate digestives. I've got some of my caravan if you're exiting the distance from the distance. How did that session go, Neil? Right.
She was better.
Was that second loser?
Yeah.
Who would you like to ride the bike now?
If you could have any rider, Neil.
You could have any rider, who would you like to ride?
Only
you. You liar, what did you say 2 minutes ago?
My favourite rider. 3 litres out, Rog.
Exactly three.
Good job, 3 litres.
He likes little people, so he wants to lose tape before that.
3.1.
Yeah.
Three steak and chips, what would you want?
Three steak sandwiches and chips and three baked potatoes with beans.
Is that an athlete?
It's not my dinner. You see the interest now that went into that conversation? None of that went into getting ready.
Pop the bike.
Pop the bike as dinner time.
And you're lucky that we're still here. We didn't go up there for it.
Now they've all missed their dinner because dinner time fell on when we were ourselves.
When you're out.
Yeah. They just make them up these packed lunches, so they haven't had any yet. Now it's like 3 o'clock, is it? Half 2, 3 o'clock?
It is. Yeah, 3 o'clock. Quarter to 3.
Yeah, so I'm going to go get changed now. Do a bit of stretching. Taz has already got my dinner now in the camper.
Fish and
chips. Just steak.
I can't take your food away from you. You sure?
You're going to eat chip. Not that. What? Fish and chips for tea. What more for you?
Yeah, so is that off to the race truck?
Yeah, I'll bring this down to the helmet truck now, and then we'll go down and get changed.
Cool.
Right, see you in a bit. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Luke.
Make a fuck all, Neil.
Him out.
Thanks, Kev.
Do you want me to hold that?
Yeah.
Go on, you turn it round and then...
Right, I'm on. So how did it go?
Yeah, not bad. Considering last weekend I was riding a 40 horsepower Manx Norton thing.
Single cylinder.
Single cylinder.
You still got all your fillings?
Cement mixer. now we're back on. And so people don't really know how much of a difference it is. Like all these kids maybe were testing last weekend or they're coming from last BHP. So
that was a question I was going to ask you. So, say for instance you do the Manx on the RC45.
Yeah.
Is there places where, on like your superbike, you'd be scratching, but then on the RC45, the weight difference means you kind of...
Yeah, you're right. You ride them all a little bit different, but you'd be surprised how close... Well, not big bikes, so not a superbike, but like 600 and stuff. You'd be surprised how close that is to like riding some of the older... classic bikes and stuff.
It's more a power thing than a weight thing.
Yeah, 600 more flow and probably the lack of brakes on the classic bikes is the biggest thing that you don't do. But
yeah, you got to brake really before you can see the corner.
There's nowhere really at the TT that you're braking crazy hard. So, I must have seen the camera, they're pretending they're working.
Thank you.
Yeah, I'm just glad to show people behind the scenes, obviously, to see what we're trying to do on my vlogs and stuff, and might do some more in the future, maybe.
It'd be awesome to do some more.
Yeah.
Yeah. We'll have to see.
Always
see what.
I just think sometimes that it's not actually that exciting. People probably think like what I do is a bit more exciting than what it actually is.
It's not.
You do a lot of waiting around and stuff, but
going back to, like, obviously, way back to when I was just coming here, like, spectating, you don't know what's inside the trucks. That's things like that is behind the scenes, just seeing what's in here.
Yeah. Scooters.
Scooters, frames.
Motor 3 bike.
Bits of engines.
This was actually supposed to be my TT bike, and it never got used for the TT this year.
So is that completely just
completely
untouched?
Yeah, untouched. It's never been run around. It's still got standard shock in, but it's built. It's got the wiring loom, everything on it ready to put the motor in.
Yeah.
But, sorry, Christy's ring.
Yeah.
Hello? Oh, yeah, you all right? Can I ring you back in 2 minutes? I'm literally just doing an outro for video. Do you wanna say something on the video?
Hi.
What, that's it?
I don't know what else to
say. Say, my name's Christy G and I'm the best editor in the whole world. Yeah,
producer, director,
and manager of Lee Johnston. And wonder what's inside the trucks and stuff. I was like, people forget like that, because I remember going to like Brands Hatch to watch World Street Bikes when I was a kid.
Yeah, yeah.
I just like thought, fucking hell, this is just all awesome and everything. But
even then, it's like World Street Bikes, but then you couldn't even go in the paddock.
No,
well,
no.
It's still can't.
Well, you never could have Brands. You can't now at Brands Hatch. You can't get across the thing. But like now, I still watch racing. Like when I went to the Southern Hunter and stuff, I was watching. What the fuck, this is amazing.
I saw that.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, I saw that on your vlogs.
Everyone was like, oh, why are you getting so excited when it's something that you do as well, but it's not the little boy in you never fucking disappears. You know what I mean? You still get excited watching.
Speed difference between watching someone go past that speed and being on it.
Yeah, because you're just sitting beside them doing 2 miles an hour. Sitting beside someone doing 2 miles an hour is fine, but stand on the side of the road and watch someone go past, it's fucking absolutely mind blowing. But yeah, so yeah, we maybe do some more of these and
give
people more of an insight into what happens.
Crossover some subscribers.
Here's the real hero of the day.
Come on, Neil.
Like and subscribe.
Oh, he's backing up.
Neil, where are you going? Beep, beep. Yeah, he's we haven't sorted out Neil's contract yet, so we won't talk for free. But we'll get that.
What do I have to pay him?
Oh, what? It cost me a fortune.
If I, if MyMoto sponsored Neil, then we would have access to this anyway.
You'd get some big branding on him, eh? You could put one of them shop banners on the front of him, just hang it around his neck.
I mean, we all know he's got a bigger following than most of the races.
Yeah. Yeah, he has. He gets fans coming all the time. T-shirts made, the lot. Bless him. Look, he's gone to the other day.
No escape, Neil.
Yeah, that's pretty much it. But, thanks for watching. Thanks for coming.
Make sure you like, subscribe, and follow Lee's YouTube channel and social media platforms. And hopefully we'll do some more next year.
Cool. Yeah, definitely.
Awesome.